work. Count them up. We in the street, but it's not enough. Give them no rest till he establish us. And the world see Jerusalem. Way up, way up, way up. Way up, way at the top of the mountains. City set on a hill. Blue pill, red pill. Count them up. We in the street, but it's not enough. Give them no rest till he establish us. And the world see Jerusalem.
They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs.
God says that the priests are dumb dogs. Because a watchdog is supposed to warn the people.
Right.
When there's danger, it's supposed to bark and warn you that there's danger. These people don't do that.
Pound for pound, blow for blow, we the greatest, now you know, real.
There is a time and there is a place for everything. Watch what the people talk about. Let me finish. And in
don't
the midst,
right,
y'all brought a mega man, Calvary Baptist Church. We just sat down with a couple ministers, a deacon, and the minister's mentor. All right? Hey, it was a good response.
We have been told things that are just not the facts.
But I did acknowledge the fact that the information that you guys are putting out is facts. So what you're bringing out is good.
So I said, you guys ought to be in the history book. I said
y'all was at the wrong time, but y'all at the right time.
Yeah.
Well, one pastor I spoke with says that this group has targeted three different predominantly black churches here on the northeast side of OKC. And this court document shows one of those head pastors filed a restraining order against the group.
Sister Scobie, where you at, brother?
Interrupted church services from a group called Israel United in Christ. The local pastors are calling it harassment. Pastor Cheryl of Greater New Zion Baptist Church says at first he thought he was their only target. Not only him, but two other churches across Northeast OKC. The Ebenezer Baptist Church taking it to the courts, filing for a temporary restraining order. And as far as Greater New Zion, they've heightened security to keep their congregation safe.
Even though I believe they're attacking us, doesn't necessarily mean they can't receive the word of God.
Hey, shalom, Most High Christ bless. Y'all already know what time it is. We in Oklahoma. Check out the family. Y'all give it up to the Most High. Hey! Hey! Hey, check this out. Listen, today the Most High God got the victory. They took us to court on some bogus charges because Christianity is mad. I say so-called. They pissed off because we bring in this Bible to our people. Listen, you ain't stopping nothing. We are not going to quit. You're not going to tire us out. We're going to continue to teach this gospel, bring this word to the children of Israel, and ain't no stopping it. Hey, and listen, we shame the hell out that dude. On the news, Lord's will, they'll play it because we shamed them on the news. So let's see what happens. But listen, this is what happens whenever you organize, you're structured, and you stay in the scriptures, all right? Brothers, be encouraged. Continue. It's the church blitz. It's a hot summer, y'all. All praise to the Most High God.
The judge says she didn't see any evidence of harassment. The group, Israel United in Christ, says it's invigorated by the ruling. But the pastor of Ebenezer Baptist Church and its members tell me this isn't over.
So God got convicted today, so we're ecstatic.
I'm disappointed in the ruling.
An Oklahoma County judge striking down a temporary restraining order against the Israel United in Christ religious group after they demonstrated on the sidewalk outside of Ebenezer Baptist Church and several other Metro Black churches following Sunday services.
Do stop this foolishness!
The IUIC says it's carrying out a Blitz the Christian Church movement.
The commandments of God are not being taught in the churches.
However, Ebenezer Baptist Church calling it harassment.
Why do y'all worship on Sunday? Where in the Bible can we read that?
We don't need you to tell us how to live our lives.
In court, the IUIC arguing they never left public property and only spoke in scripture, which includes this.
What they're misinterpreting for hatred is passion. We see ills and we're trying to fix it.
One of those ills, the group says, is tithing.
Stop taking their money, bro.
It was never monetary. What happened, Christianity over the years have morphed that into financial gain.
You cannot take a sheep or a goat or something to pay a bill. You need money.
Claiming pastors like Derek Scobie use tithing for financial gain. Thursday, the judge ruling the IUIC stayed on public property and didn't harass anyone, but they must not block traffic. Now, the IUIC says the movement is full steam ahead.
If anything, we're going to wrap it up.
This is not the end of this. It will be resolved.
In court, the IUIC argued it was hypocritical for Pastor Scobie to take legal action because he's also facing a legal battle after being arrested while protesting the night before Julius Jones's set execution. Pastor Scobie says that was peaceful. He was praying in the street and not harassing anyone and wanted to do what he could to stop the execution.
I heard you talking about shame on Pastor Scobie. Do you feel like he's been a hypocrite?
Well, concerning what happened to him, he should be a little more compassionate, understand that you're being accused of the same allegation, which really you were, because you were arrested. Police was out there. They didn't arrest one of us because they knew we weren't breaking the law.
Okay.
So that's why we say shame on him.
Okay.
He could talk to us. The Christian pastor man today, they don't want to confront us and talk to us. We're your brothers. We're not your enemies.
Okay.
We're not looking to harm anybody.
Okay.
But we're not going to turn our eye to the truth of the Bible.
Shalom, Officer Most High Christ blessed.
Shalom, Most High Christ blessed.
Why did you join IUIC?
Well, I joined IUIC because I saw men of God that was actually keeping the commandments as it is written in the Bible. Never seen that day in my life, ever. So when I saw that, I knew that it was something different about this group that I was looking at, which was actually the only group I ever looked at. I actually been congregating since 2014 of June. Fear the Most High God. Fear the Most High God. See, here's the thing. When you learn about the prophecies and know who you are and the covenant that you promised, keeping the commandments, and then the consequence when you break the commandments, I ain't going nowhere. Period. Point blank. Ain't nothing else out there. As a matter of fact, the scripture says, and I don't want to try to break that down, but 2 Peter 2:20. As you read on that, it's better that you have not known the truth than have known it and going astray. I butchered it, but. Yeah, so the fear of the Most High God, definitely, I'm here to do the work, and I'm here motivated to see what's in store. The Most High God promised us a kingdom. I'm trying to be in the kingdom.
There's somehow, in some way in your life, each one of us have something about Bezalel that moved us. Because he walked uprightly. Because he kept God's commandments. Because he taught God's commandments. He instructed his family in God's commandments.
From the evil that will come on this earth. Much more evil going to be displayed on this earth. So the Most High had to take him away from this evil that was to come on this earth. Free. So brothers and sisters, today, put our brother to lay to rest, but no, his spirit lives on. This man walk righteously. Our prayers go to the family. If you stay strong, O Lord, have confidence in the word of God. Bezalel, we love and respect you. What you did for the state.
peace is not goodbye. We both know it's not the end, yeah. So go and cry. Just know you're gonna see me again. Yeah, I fought the fight. One day we'll be side by side when you see me again.
So don't waste all of your time and effort into you aerating the soil, you putting the expensive seed down to make your yard look real pretty, but you ain't got no garden in the backyard. But the Most High tells you that the land that he gave you, he wants you to till it up, put some crops in it, so that you can eat from the land that he gave you.
To say how to serve great men with ease, because sometimes having good hospitality is not easy, right? Sometimes you got some people that got a lot of wants. Sometimes you got people to understand you're doing 8, 9, 10 different things. So guess what? You can't show like you're upset, like you're stressed out, like you're mad. You got to be able to serve these great men with ease, right? Because they deserve it. Our leadership deserves it. Best leadership on the planet. So we got to make sure we can serve them with ease.
Y'all my brothers in here. I'm serious. Every one of you my brothers. Just want to get on you is because I care. You won't even apply what God says. Well, you can be afraid now and change, or when you get intubated and you're hooked up and they're like, he's got 24 hours to live. Beep, beep. His systolic is 185, his diastolic is 110. You might want to say goodbye now, because we don't know if he's going to make it through the night. It's all a game, huh? Until you get touched.
On each other and push each other to do greatness. He wasn't scared to be great. Remember earlier he said, not afraid to be different. He wasn't afraid to be different. So what is spirit we get that we got on us now?
Everything is scriptural. Even in the music that we doing, everything is spiritual. Y'all gotta understand that. But we gotta support this.
It's nature time and we doing a stepping. Preset book a part of my uniform, so it's part of my weapon. Ain't worried about you, we doing the work. IUIC, we rapping. We take orders, we got one job. We ain't asking no questions. Hey, look, you want war with who? Deacon Icon, give me a boost. You know we came as one. Order came in, we breaking it too. Now you can put that on the news. Apologetics, they getting the blues. It ain't no secret, we Jews. They know our bishop, yeah, he got the juice. In the blink of an eye, our bodies gon' change. We keeping the laws, he told us hold fast, we ain't worried about names. We hitting them all, tell your pastor he better stay in his lane. Cause we want war, you see bombs, Babylon in flames. Who you gon' call, hold on.
It's wonderful to see all of black men together, getting along, loving each other. It's amazing.
I left the church to join God's army. We left the church to join God's infantry. Said your father was there when you left. Your mother was there when you left. Your sister, your brother, your cousins, your auntie, your uncle was there when you left. Said your father was there when you left. Your mother was there when you left. Your sister, your brother, your cousins, your auntie, your uncles. To join God's army, we left.
that you running from us. And if it's about that smoke, you don't want it from us. Listen, everywhere we go.
Yeah, I said 12 AK Udi, I got my flame back, but still got chills. Why? The bishop came back. We on A block, you cannot change that. So many others, y'all don't know what to aim at. I was taught that when you in the water, give them nothing. I was taught discussing way too much of me, need bluffing. We can pull up any time of day and it be nothing. Oh Lord, they warlords, they coming. Niggas that be running their mouth, they running, I can't stomach. And the ones that jumping out in front, they be the youngest. When you from this
trials and tribulations, friendships and betrayal. The life of a prophet is not for the weak. Success and setbacks, too many to count. I've seen a lot come and I've seen a lot go. But there's one thing I've learned. No one man can do it alone. So
season's changing, we got harder. Barely can sleep, I hit the streets, I got my guard up. I know we probably did some things that we not proud of. That's why the father had to leave us at the bottom. But I ain't tripping cause he got us. We on the mission, time ticking on that timer. Taking the kingdom, ain't no secret, bro, we got
us. I never
seen back with our power. Rise and shine, early grind, recognize I'm certified. 12 tribes worldwide, don't act like you ain't heard about it. I'm a young kind of fly.
And finally, my brother, block prophecy. He's strong in the Lord.
I'ma show you and prove to you that the Israelites are black, were always black, always will be black.
Nathaniel, yeah, he a prophet, sent back to the earth, back to the earth. He sent you to wake up the people and tell them, come out of the church, come out of the church. Be ready for war, soon as they wanna get out of the dirt, out of the dirt. Hey. Shout out one, shout out one, shout out one. Toes down, shout out one, shout out one, shout out one, toes down.
Got the juice, I ain't talking no rule, cause we walk in the light of a new day. I can't listen to nothing a few say. Thank the Lord that he showed us a new way.
Shout out one, shout out one, shout out one, toes down, shout out one, shout out one, shout out one.
Shalom, brothers. Shalom, sisters. Bishop Nathaniel here. You know what day it is. That's right. It is Shout Out Tuesday. It's Shout Out Tuesday. And you know how I love to read your letters of exhortation and your donations of support. But before I do that, I often love to cover a little bit of our hidden history. That's right, our hidden history. Shout out to Deacon Ithan for having a great show every Sunday afternoon. Check it out if you get the chance. So, our hidden history. So what I want you all to do, get your libations, get your comfort food, get your diet food, get whatever you need to relax yourself as we sit back and relax and enjoy today's lesson, okay? So let's check it, take a look at the history, and I'll come right back, all right?
All right, I got the Revised and Expanded Holman Illustrated Bible Dictionary. I'm going to go inside the book and show you some information that Christianity has hidden for centuries. I'm going over to page 224. Page 224. Let's look and see what it says when you look up the word black. Black, often used to denote the color of physical objects. Hair. Leviticus 13:31, verse 37. Song of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 11. Uh-oh. Look at the next word. Skin. So skin is referred to as black too. Let's see the reference. Job 30 verse 30, Song of Solomon chapter 1 verse 5 and 6, and Lamentations 4 and 8. Wow, wait a minute. So for all this time, we've been bringing out Job 30, 30, Song of Solomon 1, Lamentations 4 and 8, and Christians and stupid Christian apologetics been saying, no, you're not ready. We wasn't ready. It's not talking about black. No. Now they need to shut the hell up. All right. Here's the next book entitled The Varnay. Now, this is not the original copy. This is in English. Let me show you. Yeah, right over here. I'll just go to this part. This is the English version. This is not the original. Remember, the one I had was from Romania. Okay? And it was stolen. I went to the stupid moving company and they stole it. And I filed a complaint and all that. I'm so furious. So I had to order this new English version. It's not as good as the original. Nothing ever is, but I'm just going to show you what they have on the inside, which is beneficial in terms of history. All right. You know, as a matter of fact, let me go back to the beginning. Built at the command of Stephen the Great between the 24th of May and 14th of September, 1488. Varnay is today one of the best known Romanian medieval monuments. So this is a church that was built in 1488. So we're going to take a look. I want gather your kids around, gather the kids. The children can look at this. Kids can look. Okay. This is the Church of the Varnay in Romania. See somebody parked their car over there. But what I want y'all to see are the icons painted along the outside of the church. And this is what we're going to get into today. We're going to take a look at the images painted along the church. Okay, here's another angle from the book. You can see that there's things painted. Pictures painted. We didn't go in close yet. I'm just showing y'all the outside of the church. This was done in the year 1488. Here's another angle. Now, when we go in the book, many of these images that's on the outside have now, as of this year, been whitewashed. The copy that I had, the original copy of this book in Romanian, which is like a Russian dialect, similar to Russian, most of it, 80% was still black. So if you get this book, a lot of it is whitewashed. They got very few images that are still black. But I'm going to show you regardless. Okay. This is another angle, more close up on the outside of the church. You can start to see some of the black images. Let's go further in. All right. I wonder who this black fellow is. Let's see. Genesis, Adam plowing. See, they got Adam black. Next picture says Cain and Abel on the north of the facade. Cain and Abel, black. Okay. Now I can see myself how they started to put the strokes in the hair to change it and to lighten the skin. I'm going to show y'all. Watch. Y'all just bear with me. Here's an example. It's 24. This says Eve. Black. Do y'all see that? Eve, black, not Mary. Let's get some more. You can see some of them black here, but look at the faces, it's falling apart.
look, white. That it looks like they already whitewashed these. That's how it looks to me, whitewashed. But we gonna, I'm gonna keep on going through the book. Whitewashed. Let me see. These are all whitewashed here. I don't like these. Some of y'all might like some of these images, but to me, they're just too light. It's too light. Let's keep going. Now, y'all can see these images here. Darker, right? Then when you pan down, look, they're getting lighter. Look at that. Caucasian. But when you go further up, you can see the darkness of the skin tone. Okay, look at this one. Christ, black. Look at the angels around Christ, black. So how did they get from as black as this to the Caucasian ones I just showed you about a few seconds ago? This is where it was from. This is where it's from here. Look. Look at these black images of the saints and the prophets. Look how black the saints and the prophets are. This is on, says the last judgment, west facade. That's Christ in the center with the archangels around him. Look at that. Look how powerful that is. Black. Power coming from him. Look at that. 1488. The last judgment detail. Now, this one I thought was interesting, okay? I've showed y'all this before. I want y'all to look at the color difference between this guy and the angel. Look at the angel's black face. And look at this guy. And look at the white woman with chains around her neck. Let's zoom in on the angel. That's the angel we just saw, black. Here's the hand of God, black. Who's being judged? Esau, the white man. I want you to look at the color difference between this guy and the angels and the hand of God and the angel here. Look at the color difference. We know when something's been whitewashed or not. This is white folks. These, oh. How could I forget about this? White folks in chains. Edomites in chains on the judgment day. Do y'all see that? Do y'all see that? There's chains around these white folks' necks. Shackles. Look at that. Chains on their ankles. Who's passing the judgment? Look at the black angel. Look at the black hand of God. Do y'all see that? And this guy's next. But I don't want to go to the lake of fire. You're going, buddy. And you're going into slavery. For all the sins of your fathers, because you are your fathers. You are your fathers. 1488, people. 1488. Seventh Trump. Trump is blowing. The angels blowing a horn, and look at the resurrection of the dead. Look at the black faces. Y'all see that? The dead is rising. The dead. Let me try and see if I can get closer up in this book. And I'll tell you, this book is a shadow of the book that I had. Let's get some more. This is the judgment of Ishmael, the Arabs being judged. The saints, I see they tried to touch them up, but they still brown, dark brown. Let's get some more. See, in the last book I had, it said that these, if I'm not mistaken, were the prophets, black. But I can see that they touched them up. I see it. I can see it. Look at this. Look at the black angels at the bottom down here. Look at that. There's an angel. There's Mary. Look at these saints. Black. Angel, black, seraphim, black. And you know what? You got these stupid people. I'm going to say this. Listen to what I'm about to say. You got some stupid people out there that say, no, all images are sin. No, only if you worship them. Remember when the Lord had Moses tell a brother to build the Ark of the Covenant. What did he tell him? He said, put images of two angels on the Ark. When King Solomon built a temple for the Lord, he said, I want angels, images of angels in the temple. You can read about that in the book of Chronicles. He also said, I want 12 lions on the stairs and I want bullocks in the temple yard. So these dudes don't know what the hell they're talking about. They don't know the Bible. What they do hate is our people waking up to the truth that they're the Israelites. And we're coming back to the truth with proper images to show our sons and our daughters. That pisses them the hell off. All right, I'm back to the book, Russian Icons. I'm showing you these Greek Orthodox people, how they have paintbrushes, and their job is to paint over all the black images of Christ, the apostles, and all the leaders of Russia. Look, here's Christ black in the background. Let's see what this guy's doing. Let's pull back. Look, they're painting white images or painting over black images, whitewashing them as they call it. It's called iconoclasm. Look in the background here, black image of a Russian leader. They hide all his history. They all work together. They all work together. That's Christ, black. Look, painted over all the black images, made them white. That's why they say critical race theory is dangerous in schools. They don't want the Israelites to enter the school system and bring this out. Look at this. I'm going to zoom in right there. That's Mary and that's baby Christ. Well, if that's the baby Christ black, and who in the hell is this? Who in the hell is this? That's the Antichrist, the 666. Caesar Borgias. Look at all these black images. In Russia.
A treatise on physical geography. I'm gonna pull a couple of things out of this book. I just want y'all to pay very close attention. Thus the Jews are a people who have ever, according to the prophecy, dwelt alone, without intermixing with the nations to this day. Now this separate race all descended from brown ancestors. The word for right there, for means because. For Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob must have been as dark as Mar Yohanan, if not darker, exhibit every shade of color from the black Jews of Malabar. Let's jump down. The Spanish Jew is always dark complexion and his hair is uniformly black. The various shades of color observable among the Negro or African race tends to the same conclusion. Along the coast of Guinea, which is low, marshy, and hot, we find jet black complexions, and this is the very country from which American Negroes have been derived. So here they explain that the Jews are black. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob were black. All right, brothers and sisters, you saw it for yourself. Wasn't that some good stuff? I tell you, I get chills every time I read, think,
or examine our hidden history. It gives me goosebumps. I get chills. That's right. No matter how brutal our history was, you know, how brutal it was. It was brutal. But it's like, this all proves that we're the children of Israel. All that brutality, slavery, oppression, archaeology truly proves that we are the one and only real children of Israel. So what I want to do now, I want to take a look. All right, I want to all sit back. Sit back. You ain't done. Now, this might be rated PG-13. Listen good, parents. Mommies, I know a lot of you single mamas out there. Listen to what I'm about to say. Today's commentary will be somewhat PG-13. Parental guidance is advised. So get your cute, adorable little bad butt kids out their room! What we're going to do, we're going to take a look at Bishop Patrick Wooden. That's right, Bishop Patrick Wooden. And thousands of other hypocrites who condemned Beyoncé's song, Church Girl. Now, we're going to examine, did she lie? Listen good to my question. Did she lie is the question. You could be getting your feelings, but the question once again, did she lie? So let's take a look at the sermon that Bishop Patrick Wooden gave regarding Beyoncé's song, Church Girl. And I'm going to show you some clips. I'm going to interject now and then, and I'll be right back with my commentary. All right?
Beyoncé just released Sacrilege. The only thing I can account for some of this stuff is somebody done sold their soul to the devil. Now, all I can say to you is this. When you sell your soul to the devil, you get the short end of the stick. But this piece of trash that's released, and she named it Church Girl. Now, I had thought to try to read the lyrics to you, but I struggled to listen to them. It's too bad. It's too bad. It's not for public consumption. It would be a desecration if I read this. And I don't recommend it. You know, parents, I know all your little children, got they're all of them, 3 months old, they got a cell phone. But I don't recommend that you let them listen to this. It's the worst. You can, am I right? It's the worst.
But is it
you
true?
Can't get, and to sample the song of a real church lady. Tweak a clock to, I don't know whether she knew what she was going to do with the song or not.
She didn't know she was going to tell the truth. That's what the problem is.
She knows she's not saved. I don't talk about anything that's not public. Anything that's public is fair game. And I pray to God that a stiff denunciation of what she did with that song is put out. It shows that we're not speaking up. Ain't nobody, don't nobody respect the church. The world don't respect the church. See, you can't win the world enamored by them. I'm just so proud that somebody would want to use my music. What do you mean? You're one of the best in the world.
You're preaching, sir.
Oh, he ain't saying nothing.
You're preaching, sir.
We sang for Jesus. I tell you what did help me. Marchetta just released, where is she? Released hers. And that's the one you need to buy.
Because Christian that's albums are filled with democratic lies.
Got a good beat to it, if you feel like shouting.
Yes, sir.
A sanctified, unmistakably sanctified message.
Amen.
Amen. And you know, can't nobody sing any better. But for... to show this kind of disrespect for the church. And what's sad is this. There will be church people who will defend it. But let me tell you something. I'm not bothered by those who defend that kind of garbage. I'm bothered by those who say nothing.
Well, let me say something. I'm going to say something about it.
Who angers me. Am I right?
Oh, boy.
Go for it. You can get through this. Let's see this. Okay.
Christian women are embracing dance moves once reserved for strip clubs. Hmm. It's happening near Houston, and it's called Pole Fitness for Jesus.
What's it called?
Oh.
Twice.
My mom's going to kill me.
It's called what again?
It's called Pole Fitness for Jesus.
Oh, good. Okay.
The monthly pole dancing class happens on Sundays, and it's set to Christian music. Mm-hmm. Instructors say this is not about sex.
Mm-mm.
It's about connecting with God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I do feel a spiritual connection whenever you have the music on and it's singing about lifting you up and being closer to God. You do feel that. People who want to, you know, sit there and judge it, well, that's sacrilegious or, you know, that doesn't really make you a good Christian when you judge other people.
Well, the classes are free because the instructor says that she doesn't want to make a profit on God's day. This is her story, her
that's
words.
Going on. Yeah, that's not,
yes.
This is not us.
This is not.
It's all about lifting up, being closer to God. Some people can use more lifting up than others.
Oh, boy.
A lot of makeup.
Look at some of these praise and worship leaders. Some of y'all girls dressed like men. These bull daggers. And y'all don't say nothing. Y'all, the word is right when it hits me. We got to get these women in our churches delivered from these fast spirits. Got the Holy Ghost and you fast. Got the Holy Ghost, you still dressing like the world. Got the Holy Ghost and full of lust as a dog is fleas. Got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, you got it. But you need to travail, Ezra 9, so you can be fastened and nailed in that holy place. Hallelujah. Pick up the divine spirit. What's wrong with you? Well, you don't start acting like the world. The mixture. You women that don't want to be different from the world. You men that don't want to be different from the world. No, we got to be different. Everybody got to be free. The preacher got to be free and the pew got to be free. We got to get this spirit off of us. Come on, preachers. We're not playboys. We're not whoremongers. We're not hoes. We got to be free. And come on, women who like to sleep with the preacher and then want to play like you the victim after you sleep with them. The devil is a liar. We all got to get free. Hello, Bokosai. You preachers in the pulpit, you men preachers, that I don't know whether you a man or a woman. You men preachers, that your sexuality is in question because you dyeing your hair like you's a woman. Be delivered. All this mixture in the body of Christ. You women who dress like men, bull daggers. Your God is calling the church back to their first love. This mixture is in the body of Christ. And maybe I've contributed to it. 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 By trying to mix holiness with prosperity. Or trying to mix holiness with all this teaching on how to do this. But God spoke to me yesterday riding in the car. And he said, son, it's time for my people to come back to the holy place.
But you can't really cut the rug at that tempo. You could just book.
you know, you can't pick them up and put them down. You can't.
That's too slow.
Wait.
That's Chicago. Chicago is too slow. Brother Phil, your computer got demons in it. Every time I need it, it's broke. 160, 150.
Thank you.
Now, this church girl is making believe she has a demon in her, and the pastor's going to cast out the demon. But watch her movements, and I want y'all to look at how she moves, allegedly being demon-possessed, and how the rest of the church girls twerk in church. Church girls have low self-esteem with those spider eyelashes, fake hair on their head. They have nothing going for them except making it clap. I want y'all to take a look at her face. All she want to do is shake her behind. Watch her set up her camera in church to shake her ratchet, nasty, stinking behind.
Thing I'm thinking is
This girl don't have no bra. This girl in the blue cannot have no bra on. Look at, I think I just saw panties. I think I just saw panties. At least Spankies, those things that cheerleaders wear. Is there a bra in the house? Is there a bra? Oh, they didn't that's almost percolating. That's almost percolating. Look, there's panties all over the place. Where is the mother, where is her slip? This is why we used to wear slips in the house of the Lord, because you don't want to cause a brother to fall. Look at the mother's board. She's already fanning. She's hot. Why is no one stopping this? Miss Trinidad, Miss Trinidad. She got a baby thigh out. That close to... Oh, they done tooted it and booted it. You can't toot it and boot it that close to the altar. In remembrance of me is right there. She done showed me the back of her behind, and I'm married. I don't wanna be looking at this. Hey, girl in the white, so no time. Again. Okay, no bras back on. Oh man, I feel weird. Somebody should, where are the ushers with the blankets? There ain't no usher to blanket this. Oh, God. See, there's her booty again. Had to be a brother recording this. Had to be a brother. Like, I'm about to get this up. Yes, sir. Wow. She almost broke her neck. All up in her drawers. All up in her drawers. Look at this. Standing, oh, the mother's board with the white ass standing ovation. Where is the covering? Where is the covering? Oh, it sounds like a man's voice at the end. So there were men in the house. I thought this might be an all lady church, so they weren't tripping.
For tuning in today to the gospel from the stripper's pole. Yep. For tuning in today to the gospel from the stripper's pole. Yep. For tuning in today to the gospel from the stripper's pole.
Yep. Today I want y'all to look at this sister who teaches the Bible with her breasts showing, her areolas are showing. You can't make this stuff up. And y'all mad at Beyonce? Y'all better shut the hell up.
The territory as you grow. And the word was patience.
Yeah, which I lacked.
And sometimes still lack, right?
Now, this female pastor gives church members her breast to suck, says her breast milk is holy. What the hell is going on with y'all?
So at my Catholic high school, we have mass.
What's that?
It's like a church service that we have like once a month.
Okay.
So it's just like church, but for Catholic people. Okay. So we had mass, and I guess this guy I was talking to at the time, like during mass, it's like kind of boring because, you know, it's mass. So he fingered me during mass.
During church?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah. Like no one saw. I had like my school uniform on. It's like a skirt. So no one saw.
I don't even know what to say. You chose this, you couldn't just wait after?
I mean, it was the time. When the time is right, the time is right. You feel me?
What do you mean?
It was the right time. We were both in the mood. Mass was boring.
What foot did the church?
fucked in the church.
Stop it. Get some help.
Help? Nah, baby, you going to hell. Oh my God.
No, not in. In the church?
Hey, my boy, she said fuck in the church.
I fucked at a church.
Fucked in the church?
Stop.
Now, here come the homos, the girly boys.
The Christian church is a cesspool for wickedness, for filth, for evil, for fornication.
Don't forget, this is in church. In church. Y'all mad at Beyoncé, please.
Now, the pastor didn't want to read the church girl lyrics, but you know what? I'm going to read the church girl lyrics. Here's Beyoncé's church girl lyrics. And it says, ooh, ooh, I want to be centered. Ooh, ooh, I want to be centered. I want to be centered in thy will. I've been up, I've been down. Feel like I move mountains. Got friends that cried fountains. Oh, I'm warning everybody, as soon as I get in this party, I'm going to let go of this body. I'm going to love on me. Nobody can judge me but me. I was born free. I'll drop it like a thotty, drop it like a thotty. I said, now pop it like a thotty, pop it like a thotty. You bad. Misa, now drop it like a thotty, drop it like a thotty. You bad. Church girls acting loose. Bad girls acting snotty, you bad. Let it go, girl, let it go, let it out. Girl, let it out. Twerk that ass like you came up out the south. Girl, ooh, ooh. I said, now drop it like a thotty. Drop it like a thotty. I'm sorry. She ain't lying. Wait a minute, where am I at? You bad. Bad girl acting naughty. Church girl, don't hurt nobody. You can be my daddy if you want to. You can be my daddy if you want to. You can get it tatted if you want to. You, I mean, tatted means, I guess, tattoos. And they got tattoos all in the black Christian church. All right, let me get back to the song. You can get it tatted if you want to. She ain't trying to hurt nobody. Put your lighters in the sky. Get this Liddy. She gonna shake that ass and them pretty big old bitties, huh? So get your racks up, word. Get your math up, I'ma back it up, Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. I'ma bust it, bust it, bust it, bust it up, bust it up. I see them gray sweats. I see a blank check. I'm finally on the other side. I finally found the urge to smile. Swimming through the oceans of tears we cried, tears that we've cried. You know you got church in the morning, but you're doing God's work. You're going in. She ain't trying to hurt nobody. She is trying to do the best she can. Happy on her own with her friends, without a man. I'm warning everybody, as soon as I get in this party, I'm gonna let go of this body. I'm gonna love on me. Nobody can judge me but me. I was born free, born free. I'll drop it like a thotty, drop it like a thotty. I said, now pop it like a thotty, pop it like a thotty. Free, you bad, me sir. Now drop it like a thotty, drop it like a thotty. Free, you bad. Church girls acting loose, bad girls acting snotty, you bad. Let it go, girl, let it go, let it out. Girl, let it out. Twerk that ass like you came up out the south. Girl, ooh, ooh. I said, now drop it like a thotty, drop it like a thotty. You bad, bad girls acting raunchy. Church girl, don't hurt nobody, don't hurt nobody. You can be my daddy if you want to, you bad. You can get it tatted if you want to. You bad. Put your lighters in the sky. Get this motherfucking litty. You bad. She gonna shake that ass and them pretty big old bitties. She got your racks up. Ooh, get your math up. Ooh, I'ma back it up, 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 back it up. I'ma bust it, bust it, bust it, bust it. Back it up, back it up. I seen them gray sweats. Ooh, I seen them blank checks. I must be the cash, cause it ain't your face. It must be the cash, cause it ain't your face. Now do it, baby. Stick it, baby. Do it, baby. Stick it, baby. Do it, baby. Spin it, baby. Now spin it, baby. Do it. Now spend that cash a little harder, and she might let you dive in the water. Drop it like a thotty. Drop it like a thotty. Now, now, now. Drop it like a thotty. Drop it like a thotty. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Drop it like a thotty. Drop it like a thotty. Good girls acting bad. Church girls don't hurt nobody. I ain't trying to hurt nobody. Trying to bring the life up in your body. Now, that's the end of the song. Now, I was reading it. Y'all listening to it. Where's the lie? I just showed you proof, evidence of what goes on in the church. Where did Beyoncé lie at? You might be mad because she's telling the truth on you hypocrites in the Christian church. But that's all you are, a bunch of hypocrites. Just waiting for the missiles to arrive and blast you to kingdom come. Drop it like a thotty. Drop it like a thotty. Ooh, ooh, ah. Ooh, ooh, ah, she ain't lie.
Now, I want y'all to look at this line in the song. I'm finally on the other side. I finally found the urge to smile. Swimming through the oceans of tears we cried. Tears that we've cried. You know you got church in the morning, but you're doing God's work. You're going in. So this whole section here about swimming through oceans of tears reminds me of many incidents that occur in the Black Christian church, wherein sin occurs, or as it always does, major sins, and they try to cover it up, they try to hide it, they try to conceal it. Let's take a look at this video so you can see the example of why Beyoncé may have written regarding a girl that cries or swims through oceans of tears and cries.
And the video is of this woman, Sophie Morris, who got up in front of the church during testimony service, and she gave her testimony. And she began to talk about how when she was 8 years old, she was molested by her mother's boyfriend. Now, Sophie's mother was in the church, and she jumped up. That was her in the front row. And she said, "You're lying," and all this kind of stuff. And then she began to call the name of Jesus and this stuff. And then women came up, and they encircled Sophie and her mother. And the pastor took the mic out of Sophie's hand, and he dismissed the church. And as they played music, he told the church that you were dismissed. And this video really made me upset, because that is what many churches do to people who have real issues. They dismiss you. They dismiss you. And so y'all tell people, "Why don't you come to church? Why don't you come to church? Why don't you come to our church? Oh, we got power." You don't have power. You have performance. There's a big difference. I'm going to let y'all watch this clip, and I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary. If you can't handle real talk, you may not want to look at this video any further. I'll be back after this clip.
My name is Sophia. My name is Sophia Morris. I was raped at 8.5 years old. I kept it to myself. Because I didn't know who to trust. They all look like him. Eight and a half years old. Taffy, come up here.
Oh, God.
How old are you?
Eight.
I was 8.5 when my mother's boyfriend took my childhood away from me.
The blood of Jesus against that.
My mother knew about it. Okay, fine.
My God.
My mom came to me 2 days ago.
The blood of Jesus.
My mom was
no,
raped.
No,
the it's
blood.
Not that. Okay.
No, no, bring it.
Awareness.
She is lying. She is lying.
I know you
about the blood of Jesus.
She's not going to take her for that. She never loved me.
She is lying.
No.
She is lying.
We were taught at an early age that God's laws are done away with. So don't even waste your time reading about them. Everything that Beyoncé said in the song, I've witnessed growing up in the Christian church. And we, my family, what I mean, we went to various different churches. And me and my brothers and friends, we ran through many of the young girls in the church. Don't let nobody tell you different. Don't let nobody tell you different. That is not a holy institution. We saw people, married pastors, sleeping, you know, ass grabbing, kissing, licking necks with the deaconesses in the church and all that, who wasn't their wives. Listen good to what I'm saying. See, I have a different perspective on it. I went through it. I see it for what it is. Many of you commenting on the Beyoncé song, Church Girl, you got two points of view. One, you're trying to hide the evil within. Okay? Two, you've never been to church and you're making an assumption. Okay? This is why sin is so rampant in the Christian church. They teach us lessons at a young age. God's laws are done away. We never hear about the white man's laws are done away with. Never hear that. But it's always what law you read in the Bible. Forget about it. What? Forget about it. You don't got to worry about that. Oh, really? Okay. Party over here. And we smacking booties and grabbing booties and breastuses and fingering here and there. You, man, come on, stop. Come on, stop. And this is why crime is on the all-time rise like never before from church girls and church boys. Let me tell you something. The black Christian church has become the bane of our existence. I'm going to say it again. The black Christian church has become the bane of our existence. Look it up, nigga. Look it up. Bishop Wooden said Beyoncé ain't saved. Well, according to scripture, Bishop Wooden, you ain't saved either. Look it over here. Come with me over here. Matthew 24, verse 14. Verse 13. 24, verse 13. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Endure what? What we got to endure? What all that we read before that? Let's read from verse 9. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted and shall kill you. And you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. These Christians ain't hated of all nations. Bishop Wooden, you're not hated of all nations. This is pertaining to the black Israelites. Verse 10. And then shall many be offended and shall betray one another and shall hate one another. Bishop Wooden, you ain't gone through this. And many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. Bishop Wooden, you might not want to hear this, but you do fall in verse 11. You fall right up in there. Okay? Verse 12. And because iniquity, which means sin, breaking God's laws, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. That's why we don't love our neighbor as we love ourselves. That's why we commit adultery with one another. This is why we fornicate with one another. This is why we steal from one another. This is why we hate one another. This is why we covet what each other has. This is why we lie with one another. Because you churches, you black, lying, evil Christians, you have taught us from our youth God's laws are done away with. Then verse 13 reads, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. So you got to go through that. Bishop, you ain't gone through that. No. You and your little Roman Catholic outfit where you don't know the history of that outfit. Believe you me, you don't know the history of the Roman Catholic Church and what they did, the atrocities they committed against black people. Because if you did, I don't think you'd wear it. But a lot of you black Christians, because you want to belong to white supremacy, you puts it on. Okay? So unless you've endured to the end, you will not be saved. Okay? So from there, let's go to Luke chapter 1. Okay. Now, I know some of you may be thinking, well, my husband, my wife, my auntie died. Those that died as Israelites and they endured the trials they had to go through, keeping God's commandments, they will be saved. The scripture says the dead in Christ shall rise first. We can read about that in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, okay? But if you're worshiping idols, the cross, the white image of Jesus, church on Sunday, Christmas, Kwanzaa, Mother's Day, Father's Day, New Year's Eve, you are not saved. Neither will you be. You're in paganism. Let's go to Luke chapter 1 and verse 68. Watch this. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people. Who is God's people? Israel. It's telling you right there in the verse. Okay, verse 69. And hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. The horn of salvation is Christ. He's the king. He's the horn of salvation. Verse 70. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Let's ask Bishop Wooden a question. Who are the enemies, plural? Who are the enemies, plural, more than one, that the Bible is speaking of? You know why I had to stress the S? Because I've asked evil Christians, they say Satan. Satan is singular. Enemies is plural. Oh, numbskull, oh, slow belly Christians. So I'm going to read it and ask you the question again. Verse 71, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Who are our enemies and who hates us? I'll give you a minute or a few seconds. Okay, all right. You don't know. You don't know. Why? Because you were never taught that in theology school, nor will you ever be taught who your enemies are in theology school. Let's go to Deuteronomy 28. And I'm going to read verse 48. Watch this. This is what Moses said, prophesied to the 12 tribes of Israel. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, plural. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, meaning your enemies will control the food industry, and in thirst, meaning your enemies will control the water industry, and in nakedness, meaning your enemies will control the clothing and textile industries, and in want of all things includes, means you'd have to go to your enemies for education, you'd have to go to your enemies for medicine, you'd have to go to your enemies for religion. You'd have to go to your enemies for whatever you needed. You'd have to get it from your enemies. Let's read that bottom part again. And in want of all things, and he, meaning your enemy, shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee. What enemies put yokes of iron upon the necks of our people? Was it just the American white man? No. The Dutch white man did it. The Spanish white man did it. The French white man did it. The British white man did it. I want y'all to listen good to what I'm saying according to scripture. Let's read that bottom part again. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee. When did the yoke of iron come off our neck? Read that bottom part again. Until he have destroyed thee. The yokes came off when we were mentally and spiritually destroyed. When they destroyed Israel from our minds. When they taught us we were Negroes, Afro-Americans, black. And they said, you are a Baptist. We go, yes, I'm a black Christian. Yes, I'm a black Catholic. Yes, I'm a black Baptist. Yes, I'm a black Seventh-day Adventist. Seventh Jehovah Witness, whatever the hell they are. I don't know their names. That's what it means, until he have destroyed thee. Then they said, take the yoke of iron off them niggas' necks. Now you walk around and think you're free, but you are mentally bound in bondage because you don't know who you are. You don't know your race of origin. You don't know your land of origin. You don't know nothing. You don't know who your God is. You don't know who your king is. You go God and Jesus, but in your mind there's a Caucasian man. Boop, boop, boop. White man. White man is God. White man is Jesus. Are y'all kidding me? Let's jump over to Deuteronomy 28, verse 68. Watch this. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. The word Egypt means bondage, with ships. Now, who went into bondage with ships? Slave ships is talking about. Who went into bondage with slave ships? I'll wait. Do 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 do. Do, 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 do. All right, time is up. Who went into slavery on ships? Us, our race, our people. Okay. Did the Native Americans go into slavery with ships? Yes. Read the history. They put them on ships and took them to London, took them to England. What about the Mexicans and Puerto Ricans? Yes, they put them on slave ships, took them to Spain and Rome. See, a lot of you don't, you glance through history. And you make stupid, asinine statements like, the Latino never went in slavery on ship. Shut your mouth. God, oh Lord, have mercy. Let's read Deuteronomy 28 again. Deuteronomy 28, 16. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. Watch this. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies. Oh, here's that word again. Being sold unto your enemies. Who was sold to their enemies? Were we not sold to the white man? Were we not sold to the American white man? The Dutch white man? The French white man? The Spanish white man? Were we not sold to them as slaves? And I'm leaving a lot of them out. Okay, let's read that part again. And there you shall be sold unto your enemies, for bond men, meaning slave men, and bond women, meaning slave women, and no man shall buy you. That means no man shall redeem you. That's what that means, from your condition, from the curses God put on us. There's only one redeemer, that's the Savior, Jesus the Christ, okay? He's the redeemer, okay? He died on the cross to redeem us from the curse of the law. What I read to you were two of the curses of the law, slavery. Okay, so for example, when you look at Galatians 3, because I know some of you Christians, they taught you this part, I think. Galatians 3 and verse 13, Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, curses everyone that hangeth on a tree, meaning a cross. So what does it mean? He redeemed us. If he redeemed us from the curse of the law, Bishop Nathaniel, why are we still suffering from the curses of slavery, like oppression, like systematic racism? Why are we still suffering from it? Because these curses have a time limit. Listen good to what I'm saying. These curses have a time limit. Can I prove that in the scriptures? Yes. Let's go to Luke. Come on, come with me. Luke 21 and verse 22. It reads, for these be the days of vengeance. This is Christ speaking regarding the curses. For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled. So all the curses that were written about the destruction of the 12 tribes of Israel has to be fulfilled. Okay, we're at the end now. The slave ship prophecy is ended. Okay, we got some of our brothers and sisters still in literal slavery in places like Mauritania, Libya, Saudi Arabia, Iran, and Iraq. They're going to be redeemed. Believe you me, they're going to be redeemed. What Christ did on the cross, like I said, the time is almost up. We're at the end of this thing now. We're at the end. This gospel must be preached. Okay? I want y'all all to understand that. So, when we go back to Luke chapter 1, based on what Bishop Wooden was saying about Beyoncé ain't saved, and I said, well, Bishop, neither are you. Luke chapter 1, verse 71. One more again. That we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us. Now we know who our enemies are. Then it says that from the hand of all that hate us. Those that hate us. I know some of you, you got what you call good white friends. I got good white friends. They don't hate me at all. I know, and it's the black woman that generally says that. Luke 26 and verse 17. Watch this. Leviticus 26, verse 17. And I will set my face against you. This is what the Lord said he's going to do to us. And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. Slain before enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you, and ye shall flee when none pursueth. The Bible prophesies that they that hate you shall reign, meaning rule over you. Who's reigning, who's ruling over the black man and black woman today? No, it ain't the Arabs. Nope. No, it ain't the Chinese. Nope. It's the white man. It's the white man. They're the enemies, first and foremost, and they're the ones that hate us. Well, they don't hate us, brother. They don't hate us. Let me give an example of hatred. Watch this. Everybody, all these ministers, I'm starting with the white man. I'm going to talk about him first. He has established theology schools worldwide. Now, let's read the description of Jesus Christ. Revelation chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ. Now, let's just get to the point. Verse 14. We're reading about the description of Jesus. His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow. So Christ had white wool hair. Okay? It says like wool because sheep have wool hair. It's like that, meaning it's similar to that, meaning Afro hair. Then it reads, and his eyes were as a flame of fire. When you read Genesis 49, verse 12, it says, the Messiah's eyes shall be red with wine. Verse 15, and his feet like unto fine brass. Brass is brown. As if they burned in a furnace. Now, if you burn anything in a furnace, it gets very, very dark, almost black. Hell, you burn white rice in a furnace, it gets dark. And his voice as the sound of many waters, meaning he spoke loud. So you mean all these Christians that went to theology school, I'm starting with the white man first and foremost, they never read this description of Jesus Christ, that his hair was white like wool, white as snow. They didn't read that his feet was like fine brass as if they burned in a furnace. Oh, no. They've read it. Let me tell you something, brothers and sisters. They've read it and they have hated it. Why? Because some of you simple Christians go, well, why they never taught it to us? Why would your enemies teach you that you have a king that looks like you coming to redeem you and enslave your oppressor? How stupid could you be? Your oppressor, who is your enemy, has hated you and reigned over you. Like we read in Leviticus 26, 17, Luke 1, 71. So they gave you their image to worship. Blonde-haired, blue-eyed, pink-skinned Jesus. That's what they gave you. To this day, your mothers, fathers, sons, and daughters, hell, some of you beat your children to go worship that image. Worship that false image of utter racism.
Yeah, it's racism. Because, for example, you have pictures of your mothers and fathers. Suppose somebody takes those pictures and makes them Caucasian. Is that called love? Is that love for you or hate? It's hate because they hate the way you look. So the black image of Jesus that's described right here in the Bible, they have hated it. And they gave us a Caucasian image, their image. Worship me, worship me. This is why your friendship with them depends on whether or not you worship them or not. Or you say something stupid like, kind of doesn't matter to me. Then you can still be their friend. But the second you say, I believe that Jesus Christ was a black man with white wool hair. Friendship is over. Friendship is over. Y'all are simple. Y'all ain't realized that yet. Y'all stupid as hell. These people have an innate hatred for you, what you look like, your God, your Savior, your King, your race. I hope y'all understand that. So, I made mention that Bishop Patrick Wooden, he's wearing Roman Catholic clothing. Now, some of you say, God don't care about your clothing. Y'all, you simple as hell. I'm going to give you an example. Here comes a drag queen, a man dressed as a woman. He says, I repent in the name of Jesus. Now, if his repentance is sincere on the inside, what will begin to change as well as the inner man? The outer man. Okay, the outer man will begin to change. For example, I'm going to give you scripture. Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5. Watch this. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God. So if a drag queen repents, allegedly, would he continue to wear women's clothes with those stupid spider eyelashes and wigs and makeup and high heels, skirts? Would he continue to do that? No. He'd obey that law. See, a lot of you don't realize that when you repent, you're repenting to change your way towards God's laws. This is why I always say a lot of you people in the church, all of you people in the Christian, none of you have repented. None of you. Because you say, come as you are and stay as you be. Jesus loved the little children. Rend your heart, not your garment. He don't care how you dress. Y'all stupid as hell. You got a man dressed as a woman sitting up in your church.
Talking to you is standing by this blue pole. Yeah, you. Can you sit under the aisle, please? Can you leave my church and go put on man clothes? And don't come here like that no more.
Thank you, Jesus.
I hold a standard in here. Mm-hmm. Whatever you do on the outside is your business. But I will not let drag queens come in here. And y'all gonna come in here, you're gonna dress like a man. Now, whatever you do on the outside, that's your business. But when you come in this house, if you a man, dress like a man. If you a woman, you dress like a woman. I'm not going to allow it. My salvation is more important. And God is holding me accountable. Now, whatever you do outside these doors, I don't bash, I don't judge. But when you come in here, you will not be a drag queen.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost tells me in my spirit that is drag queen sitting here with wigs on, I'm going to ask you to be removed from the sanctuary. I will not play this game. You will not, I don't care if you don't clap and you don't like it, don't come here. You will not be playing wings and heels and fooling people up in here.
Come on.
You can fool people, but see, I got the Holy Ghost for real. I can pick your spirit up in the back of the church.
Hallelujah.
Now, if you don't know me, don't come here and play with me. Okay, I can pick the spirit up. He was bothering my spirit.
Amen.
I had to see what he had on.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
That's a man. That's not a woman. Amen.
You got women dressed as men sitting up in your church. And all these women Friday night just got paid. They thumping, they thought, and they dropping it like it's hot. Saturday night, they dropping it like it's hot. One night stands, then come to church Sunday morning and praise white Jesus. Y'all insane. This is why I always say a lot of y'all going to die here in America. And when I say die, I'm talking about the spiritual die, the everlasting, the eternal die. That's what I am talking about. I'm not talking about your physical body, because all physical bodies going to die. I'm talking about that everlasting death, that everlasting condemnation. That's what I am talking about. So watch this. Let's go to the book of Daniel, chapter 12 and verse 2. It reads, "And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake." That's when Christ returns. Watch this. "Some to everlasting life and some to shame and everlasting contempt." You see that part, everlasting contempt? That's what I'm talking about. That's y'all in a Christian church. The Lord gonna kill a lot of y'all if you don't repent. Because you got the stupidest traditions, the most evil customs. Okay, drag queens could stay a drag queen. Trainees could stay a trainee. God is all love. You don't got to change for God. What, are you kidding me? You know what's funny about that? You go to work and you got to change to conform yourself to the culture of your job. But not when it comes to the creator of heaven and earth. You don't got to conform to him, though. You do whatever the hell you want to do. Y'all are simple. I don't know who raised you. I don't know what's wrong with y'all. Watch this, Zephaniah 1 and 8. I made a mention about, I know I'm just jumping all over the place, so I'll bear with me. I made mention about, what's his name? Bishop Wooden and that Roman Catholic outfit he got on in. And I made a joke and said, you Christians jump up and say, "Ran your hide, not your garment." Don't even know what that means. When you read Zephaniah chapter 1 and verse 8, watch the prophecy. "And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice," that's destruction, "that I will punish the princes and the king's children and all such as are clothed with strange apparel." You know what strange apparel is? Clothing that does not fit with what the Bible says. You know how Numbers 15 tells us to wear fringes with a border blue? You know how the Song of Solomon says to put studs of silver in your garment? Studs of gold. You know that? You know those things like that? You know how the scriptures say women should cover their head when they pray or prophesy and men should uncover their head? And you reject all that the Bible says. This is what it's talking about. I'm going to read it again. Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 8. "And it shall come to pass in that day," excuse me, "and it shall come to pass in that in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children, and all such as are clothed with strange apparel." So you keep on telling that drag queen that he or she ain't got to change the way they dress. You leading them to hell, and you going right there along with them. I'm talking about the lake of fire when the missiles hit. That's where you're going. That's where you're going. And this is why a lot of churches are afraid to deal with the Israelites, Israel United in Christ. We make ourselves open and available to you. Some of you are listening. You're taking heed to what you're being warned about in the scriptures. Like we've been telling you, we don't want your congregations. We don't want them. Those are your congregation. Fine. Just teach them right. That's all we're asking. Just teach them right. Okay. So back to Beyonce's song, "Church Girl." Y'all mad. Y'all mad because she told what? The truth. Now, I'm not saying Beyonce is born again and has repented. No, you can tell by the things she indulges in visually on the screen that she has not changed her life towards the Black Messiah. She has not. She's not given her heart and soul to the Lord of heaven and earth. Not at all. Not at all. So nobody's saying that. So please don't misunderstand and say, oh, he's agreeing with Beyonce. And talking about another thing the pastor said, Bishop Wooden said, he said she sold her soul to the devil. Well, Bishop, so did you, with your Roman Catholic inquisitor outfit on. All right? So do you, what God's laws are done away with. So have you sold your soul to the devil. Okay? Now, Matthew 19, watch this. Listen good. So you may ask, what is the road to salvation? What is the key of deliverance, to be delivered? Let's go to Matthew chapter 19. I want all you good Christian folk. You know who you are, the Christian, anyway, Matthew 19, 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments. If thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments. If thou wilt enter into life. What does he mean, enter into life? Salvation. Being saved. Being delivered. From what? From your enemies. From those that hate you. He said, do what? Three words. Keep the commandments. You hear what the Son of God said? Keep the commandments. Notice the question. What good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? Watch this. I'm going to give you another precept. Let's go to the last book of the Bible. Revelation 22, verse 14. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Wait, let's read that again. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Let's read it one more again. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Have y'all been taught to do God's commandments? You listening, have you been taught by your Christian church to do God's commandments? I'm reading the last book, last chapter of the book, Revelation 22, verse 14. You can't go around this. You can't go under it, to the left of it, to the right of it, above it. This is going in exactly what Christ said in Matthew 19, 16, and 17. When a young man asked Christ, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? Christ said, keep the commandments. Now we're in the last book, Revelation 22, 14. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. That's New Jerusalem. I know a lot of you want to enter. That's listening. I want to enter. Okay, watch this. For without, meaning outside the city, are dogs. Oh, it's calling you evil Christians dogs. And sorcerers. Oh, now it's calling y'all sorcerers. And whoremongers. Oh, you got that right. Whoremongers. And murderers. Oh, it's calling y'all murderers. And idolaters. Oh, you worship idols. And whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. See, when Christians tell you, come as you are, stay as you be, that's a lie. That's not biblical. That's not Bible. When Christians tell you, celebrate Christmas, Mother's Day, worship on Sunday as the new Sabbath, those are lies. Okay? When Christians tell you, you don't got to change your outward appearance to conform to what the Bible says, that's a lie. So again, verse 15, for without are dogs and sorcerers and whoremongers and murderers and idolaters and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. You hear this, Christians? I hope it echoes in your head. Let's go to Revelation 14 and 12, please. Revelation 14, verse 12. It reads, here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God. That keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. So you need those two things, the commandments and faith in Jesus. You need it. A lot of you just say, oh, I believe in white Jesus. No, first of all, white Jesus is wrong. But then some of you try to be slick. I believe Jesus was black. But I ain't keeping no commandments, then to hell with you. You ain't making it. You ain't going to make it. Now watch this, Revelation 21 and verse 12. This is about New Jerusalem. Watch what it says. And had a wall great and high, and had 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels, and names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. So in the names of the gates, one gate has the name Judah. Why? for the tribe of Judah to enter in. Another gate has the name Benjamin. Why? For the tribe of Benjamin to enter in. Another gate has the name Levi on it, for the tribe of Levi to enter in. Another gate has the name Ephraim. Why? For the tribe of Ephraim to enter in. Another gate says Manasseh. Why? For the tribe of Manasseh to enter in. Another gate says Simeon. Why? For the tribe of Simeon to enter in. Another gate says Gad. Why? For the tribe of Gad to enter in. So forth and so on. Listen good to what I'm about to say. There is no gate that says Baptist. There's no gate that says Catholic. There's no gate that says apologetic. There's no gate that says Seventh-day Disadvantaged. There's no gate that says Jehovah Witness. There's no gate that says Mormon. There's no gate that says African Methodist Episcopal. Those are figments of your imagination, traditions of men. You'll die in your sins, brothers and sisters, if you don't come out of those false religions. All I could do was warn you. All my job, just like all the rest of my brothers, our job is to warn you. Come hell or high water, you will be warned. And you're being warned. And then what? We shake the dust. We keep it moving. Okay? Bishop Wooden said, don't nobody respect the church. Well, you got that right. Nobody respect the church. Let me tell you about, not. I already showed you a visual and proof of my standpoint about the Black Christian church. Is filled, it's a cesspool of sin. Cesspool of sin. Now, I'm not saying that other, like amongst us, that there's no sin. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying, they will not preach God's laws to condemn sin. They'll justify and make excuses for sin. That is what I'm saying. They've been a bane of our existence. They're the reason, the Black church is the reason many of our young boys and girls are incarcerated. Why? For committing crimes. Another word for crime is sin. Let me say it again, in case you're confused, because I know you're Black. Another word for crime in the Bible is sin. When you break God's law. No, brother, no. See, all you got to do, if you keep the law of the land, that's all you got to do. Well, Romans 13 tells you to obey the laws of the land. Okay. The laws of the land you are supposed to keep. Nobody's saying not to do that. But guess what the laws of the land are based on, pretty much? The laws of God. That's right, the laws of God. Where do you think they get the laws of murder from? The Bible. Where do you think they got that homosexuality was wrong for centuries? Now they say, oh, are we going to make a change now? They got it from Leviticus 18. The incest laws, Leviticus 18. All the sexual laws, Leviticus 18. Adultery is on the books. I bet you didn't know that. Now, did ya? So the church, the Black church, nobody respects the church. Well, you got that right, Pastor. You got that right. Y'all won't even come out and talk to your brothers about the scriptures. Some of your churches is kung fu fighting. Coming out with weapons to a peaceful group of brothers. We come to you in peace. You coming out with guns and with knives. You sending women out there to kick, punch, and spit. Y'all are evil. You Christian churches, a lot of you are the devil, the Bible speaks of. You're right in line with the white man because that's your master, the so-called white man. You get mad if you want. It's all right. Your anger's not with me, truly. It's with the one true God. Because I'm telling you as God is telling you. Now, you say, oh, well, you shouldn't say that our God is the white man and all that. Well, whose God was the scribes and Pharisees? Who did they give their allegiance to? I'll wait. Do, 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 do. Okay, since you don't know, let's go to John 11. John 11, verse 47. It reads, then gathered the chief priests and the Pharisees a council and said, what do we? For this man doeth many miracles, speaking about Christ. Verse 48. If we let him thus alone, all men will believe on him. And the Romans, who? and the Romans, whoo, and the Romans shall come and take away both our place and nation. Who gave the scribes and Pharisees their place in society? Rome. Who gives these bishops and pastors and reverends and ministers their positions? Rome. Or let me say it this way, America, the white man. You got to go to their theology schools to get set up, to get your grants and get your nice little buildings and all that. Gino Jenkins know what I'm talking about. Gino, you know what I'm saying? Hey, T.D. Jakes, you know too. Creflo, you know what I'm talking about, bro. You know what I'm talking about. Ah, oh, boy, you can't make this stuff up. So your allegiance is to your oppressor. Remember, Rome was oppressing the Israelites. So why was the Pharisees and the scribes so enamored to do what Rome said? No, it's not so much obey the powers of the land, the law of the land. No, it's beyond that. They loved Rome. They loved Rome. Just like, and they didn't want the Lord to deliver them from that. No. It's just like today. You Christians talk about the return of Christ. You don't want to leave America. No, you don't. No, you don't. Okay, you want to stay here. It's in here. You want to stay here. That's what you want to do. You love this place. God bless America. Ah! You love this place. You love captivity. You love oppression. Why? Because you have money. And the mass majority of your people do not. You love this place. You love this place. You're going to die in this place. All right. All right. So I'm going to call it short. I'm going to call it quits now. All right, brothers and sisters. So let's get to the reading of the shout out letters and donations, shall we? All right, let's get to the reading of the shout out letters and donations. This is going to be a quick one. It reads, to IUIC family, Most High in Christ bless. I am Mr. Obi, writing from Las Palmas de Gran Canaria, Spain. Wow, somebody from Spain. All right. I want to send my donation to the good work of God to IUIC, but the challenge is only through Western Union. I gave the sender this address, P.O. Box 2695, Newburgh, New York, 12550, but they need someone that will receive the money there. His name. If you can forward it to me, I will be glad. My WhatsApp number is blankety blank blank blank. All right. Excuse me. Why don't you just keep sending it the way you're sending it, you know? I'll have somebody reach out and call you, though. The next letter reads, thanks for the shout out on Shout Out Tuesday. I heard it. I was watching on IUIC TV. Shout out to IUIC TV. Shalom. We thank the Most High for IUIC. Left the church 8 months ago. All praises to the Most High. This is from J.L. Pearson, all praises. Shout out, all praises. Next one reads, to all, prayers and blessing, donation for the Booster Club, Louise P. of Arlington, Virginia. All praises, all praises. All right, the next one says, please don't share on Shout Out Tuesday. No need, we just want to thank you. All right, all right. That's from... Okay, we will not read that on Shout Out Tuesday. All right. We want to give some shout out of thanks to Sheila K. and Jada R. Shout out of thanks to Charles and Laura. All praises. Shout out of thanks to, okay, I can't read this signature. It says all praises to the Most High, but then there's some scribble next to it.
You know who you are, and the Lord does too. Shout out of thanks to Sandra R. All praises. Shout out of thanks to J.L. Shout out of thanks to Louise E.P. Shout out of thanks to Louise E.P. again. Shout out of thanks to Marsha H.S. All praises. Shout out of thanks to Constance P.P. of Birmingham, Alabama. Shout out of thanks to Sam E. of Nanticoke, Pennsylvania. And last but not least, shout out of thanks to Zenora Y.M. All praises, all praises. Brothers, sisters, you know how I love to say, let's all of us stay healthy, let's stay faithful, let's stay focused, but most of all, let's all of us stay in the spirit. Most High in Christ bless you all. Shalom, love you.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed, but at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.